This is the core of the system, consisting of a signal analyzer, a display, and sensors. These are EMATs, a magnetically coupled acoustic transducer, which in this case are on an engine valve, exciting acoustic resonance on the valve stem in a very localized area between the sensors. The signal display shows the resonance occurring in that region at, in this case, about 3.5 megahertz. This resonance will be monitored for changes to either its frequency or amplitude, which will indicate the presence of defects or different conditions. In scanning along the engine valve, we can detect several different defective conditions, including an improperly drilled hollow stem, defects resulting from the forging process, a low bonding strength friction weld for a bimetallic valve, straightening cracks, improper hardening of certain regions, improperly formed keeper grooves, and even for overall dimensional conformity. In this case, there's a crack, and with the sensors directly over the crack, the signal goes away. Amplitude is greatly diminished, and in this case, there's no resonance at all. So for the inspection of the engine valves, we position the transducers in a fixture, in this case associated with some actuation, which allows us to profile the part. Here's a software interface that allows us to do that. And with precisely controlled motion, we can map the behavior of the resonance along the length of the valve stem. And here's an example of the profile that's generated. You have frequency information here and amplitude information here. And in looking for defects, we will use these profiles to compare the behavior of different test pieces. Here I've got a sample representative of a good production part that I am scanning to teach the machine what a normal part might look like. Normally, this sample population would be consist of a more diverse group than one part. So in this case, because it was the same part scanned several times, the scans are identical or close to it. But that is the profile of this one good part. By pressing that button, the computer has generated settings that describe the bounds of the sample that we just took. So we have some acceptable range that we expect good parts to fall within based on that. Once we've populated that sample and established those boundaries, this file can be saved. For use in the automated testing mode, where all subsequent parts will be tested against that file.